आप सभी से निवेदन है, कृपया अपने अपने स्थान ग्रहण करें। नमस्कार। सूचना प्रसारण मंत्रालय के फोटो प्रभाग की ओर से 6वें राष्ट्रीय फोटोग्राफी अवार्ड समारोह में हम आप सभी का हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। हम स्वागत करते हैं सूचना प्रसारण मंत्री माननीय वेंकैया नायडू जी का, सूचना प्रसारण राज्य मंत्री कर्नल राज्यवर्धन राठौर जी का, और हम उन फोटोग्राफर्स का भी यहाँ हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं जिन्हें आज फोटोग्राफी अवार्ड से सम्मानित किया जाएगा। देश की समृद्ध कला, संस्कृति, धरोहर, समाज, विकास, इतिहास, परंपराओं, लोगों को फोटोग्राफी की आर्ट और टेक्निक के माध्यम से दर्शाने का काम देश के व्यावसायिक और एमेच्योर फोटोग्राफर्स करते हैं, और आज उन्हीं को प्रोत्साहित करने के लिए हर वर्ष की तरह फोटोग्राफी अवार्ड्स प्रदान किए जाएंगे। द सिक्स नेशनल फोटोग्राफी अवार्ड्स फंक्शन इज एन इवेंट टू सेलिब्रेट द स्पिरिट ऑफ फोटोग्राफी, to salute those who have shown us new dimensions and colors of this world through their lens. और सबसे पहले हम अपने माननीय विशिष्ट अतिथियों का यहाँ स्वागत अभिनंदन पुष्पों के माध्यम से करेंगे। हम अनुरोध करेंगे सूचना प्रसारण सचिव अजय मित्तल जी का कि वो सूचना प्रसारण मंत्री माननीय वेंकैया नायडू जी का पुष्पों से स्वागत करें, आपकी तालियों की गड़गड़ाहट के साथ। हम प्रधान महानिदेशक पीआईबी फ्रैंक नरोना जी से निवेदन करेंगे कि सूचना प्रसारण राज्य मंत्री कर्नल राज्यवर्धन राठौर जी का यहाँ पर आपकी तालियों के साथ स्वागत करें। और हम अनुरोध करेंगे डायरेक्टर फोटो प्रभाग अभिषेक दयाल जी से कि वो स्वागत करें सचिव सूचना प्रसारण अजय मित्तल जी। चेयरमैन ज्यूरी कमेटी डॉक्टर एस एन सिन्हा जी, और प्रधान महानिदेशक पीआईबी फ्रैंक नरोना जी का आपकी तालियों के साथ शुक्रिया। और कार्यक्रम का शुभारंभ हमेशा की तरह आराधना से करेंगे। सरस्वती वंदना प्रस्तुत करेंगे गीत और नाटक प्रभाग के कलाकार। अमृत मंत्र नव प्रिय स्वतंत्र नव, अमृत मंत्र नव भारत में भर दे, भर दे भारत में भर दे। जगमग जग कर दे, भर दे जगमग जग कर दे, भर दे पर नव स्वर दे, भर दे भर दे। मौका है जबकि हम देश के फोटोग्राफर्स के बेहतरीन फोटोग्राफ्स को देख रहे हैं और निश्चित तौर पर इन फोटोग्राफ्स ने हम सबको एनरिच किया है, हमारे एक्सपीरियंस को एनरिच किया है। मैं अनुरोध करूंगी डायरेक्टर फोटो डिवीजन श्री अभिषेक दयाल जी को कि वो आए और अब स्वागत भाषण करें।
ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग श्री वेंकैया नायडू जी, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग कर्नल राज्यवर्धन राठौर जी, सेक्रेटरी इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग श्री अजय मित्तल जी, प्रिंसिपल डायरेक्टर जनरल श्री फ्रैंक नरोना जी, चेयरमैन ऑफ द ज्यूरी श्री एस एन सिन्हा, मीडिया हेड्स, अवार्ड विनिंग फोटोग्राफर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई एम थैंकफुल टू ऑनरेबल इंफॉर्मेशन ब्रॉडकास्टिंग मिनिस्टर फॉर ग्रेसिंग दिस ओकेजन विद हिज एस्टीम्ड प्रेजेंस। सर, आई एम कॉन्फिडेंट दैट योर प्रेजेंस एंड वैल्यूएबल वर्ड्स विल गो अ लॉन्ग वे इन गिविंग इनकरेजमेंट टू ऑल ऑफ अस। The 6th National Photography Award function is an occasion to salute our immensely talented photographers and their beloved art. Their lenses have captured the world for us and recorded the highs and lows of our times for posterity. Moreover, the intense commitment shown by the photographers to capture the perfect shot, often in face of adversity, is a matter of inspiration for all of us. The technology of photography keeps on changing, but behind the lenses are the people who have the unwavering resolve to be true and credible to the society. Photographers add a crucial dimension to journalism, credibility, and they are aware of this. Rarely do we find a photograph that lies or misleads. A perfect shot is one which captures the moment in its context and evokes empathy. The jury committee for these awards is a team of renowned and eminent photographers who have spent their valuable hours in rigorous scrutiny to select the best from the outstanding entries that we received for these awards from across the country. Let me briefly introduce the members of the jury. Dr. S. N. Sinha, the chairman of the jury, a photojournalist by profession, is the president of Indian Journalists Union. He served as the photo editor in Hindustan Times for a long period of 30 years. Dr. Sinha headed the photo operations team of Delhi Commonwealth Games. Winner of numerous national and international awards and recognitions, his photographs have been exhibited in India and abroad. Shri Dhritiman Mukherjee is one of the most respected contemporary nature photographers in India. He specializes in documenting the rare and endangered wildlife in the country. As a professional photographer, his work is being published by reputed organizations like the BBC, National Geographic, New York Times, Lonely Planet, and London Geographic, to name just a few. He is not attending the function today as he prefers to be underwater with his camera in the frozen lakes of Russia at this point of time. Shri K N Sant Kumar is the editor of the Kannada Daily, Prajavani, and monthly Mayura. He is a member of the board of directors of the Press Trust of India and a member of the executive committee of the Indian Newspaper Society for more than 20 years. Shri Sant Kumar has a keen interest in sports photography. Beginning with his Seoul Olympic Games in 1988, he has covered all the 8 Olympic Games since then as an accredited photographer for his newspaper group. Sir, if you can wave to the crowd. Thank you. The Lifetime Achievement Award is being given to Shri Raghu Raiji, whose body of work has contributed in reflecting the various dimensions of development of Indian society over the last 5 decades. The themes that he has worked on during his illustrious career shows his deep and abiding love for the country. Capturing the beauty of cities like Delhi and Calcutta, the soul of our classical musicians, the music of nature, the vastness of love of Mother Teresa, and the immortality of monuments like Taj are but one aspect of his work. His contribution in developing the art and profession of photojournalism in the mainstream media in the country is his lasting contribution to our society. For Professional Photographer of the Year, the theme of a Skilled India was chosen to document the real life stories of changing India. For Amateur category, the theme was Swachh Bharat, to capture the huge amount of work that is being done by the common man to build a clean India of our dreams. It gives me immense pleasure to inform you that the photo division is an important arm of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting that has the mandate to click, document, and archive photographs related to the government and to aid official publicity efforts of the various media units of the ministry. The division permanently preserves photographs of rare events. Its archive has a historical value, and it is making all efforts to preserve it through digitalization of all negatives and slides. I once again thank our eminent photographers for bringing to us the images which would else have faded in our memories with the passage of time. I congratulate the winners and wish them all the best in their future endeavors. I thank you all.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अभिषेक जी. कहते हैं फोटोग्राफ्स बोलते हैं, वो अभिव्यक्त करते हैं, वो दिखाते हैं उन कोनों को, उन किरदारों को, उन लम्हों को जो हम अक्सर देख नहीं पाते. निश्चित तौर पर फोटोग्राफ्स हमें एक नई दुनिया जो कि इमेजिनेशन और क्रिएटिविटी की दुनिया है उस तरफ ले जाते हैं. और आज ऐसे ही फोटोग्राफर्स को हम यहाँ पुरस्कृत कर रहे हैं और उन्हीं के काम को दिखाने वाले ब्रोशर को अब हम रिलीज़ करेंगे. हम निवेदन करेंगे सूचना प्रसारण मंत्री माननीय वेंकैया नायडू जी से कि ब्रोशर का लोकार्पण करें और सभी विशिष्ट अतिथि इसमें शामिल हों. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. फोटोग्राफ्स की इतनी सारी एंट्रीज में से कुछ को चुनना निश्चित तौर पर एक मुश्किल काम रहा, लेकिन ज्यूरी ने इस काम को बखूबी अंजाम दिया. और अब हम आमंत्रित करेंगे चेयरमैन ज्यूरी कमेटी डॉक्टर एस एन सिन्हा जी को कि वो आएँ और इस पूरी प्रक्रिया के दौरान अपने अनुभवों, अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस को हमसे शेयर करें. डॉक्टर एस एन सिन्हा.
Respected Venkaiah Naidu ji, Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore ji, Ajay Mittal ji, Mr. Naroma, Abhishek Dayal sir. Friends, first of all, I along with my colleagues, senior colleagues, very distinguished colleagues, Mr. Sanat Kumar and Dhritman Mukherjee, as Abhishek ji has just said, he loved to be take photographs, and today also he has gone in Russia for an underwater photography. So he was out. So on behalf of all of three of us, we thank the ministry for choosing us for this job. It was really a privileged job for all of us. Friends, nowadays we all live in a world which is a visual world. Nowadays people believe more in pictures. Till they don't see a visual, they don't believe. So this world becomes a visual world. And the photographer who creates that, this art, when he creates it, he creates through his vision, transformed through his technology, through his camera. And he has to be perfect in both. If his vision is not there, then he will not able to create a good picture. If his technology know-how is not there, then also he will miss his main movement. So he has to be need to be a perfect on all this, which is needed. When we selected this pictures, it was a big job. Because whoever creates a picture, it is his job. And it is always a good job which he do. But when we select pictures, we select from our angle, from our view, keeping in mind the subject, what was given, and other aspects of the photography. That was the whole idea behind it. So we, whenever we choose something, it is not this, that others have not done a good job. They all have done a very good job, and we select some out of that. So this is my personal feeling, we always feel. And we all three felt this all the time. So we received more than 300 participants' entries from 29 states, from all over the complete country, nearby, for all states. And the number of photographs in thousands. So it was a tough job. So not easy to choose all this. And that shows the popularity of this award also. And Venkaiah ji, it really goes credit to your ministry. Because how people become interested, so many entries coming there. it shows that popularity of this award. So it's a big thing. And all the participants, more than 300 who have participated, I really thank them for making it a success. We are really thankful to them. Friends, for Lifetime Achievement Award, we have a number of names from all over, again, from different parts of the country. Good names came. They all are great photographers, no less than one. But when we decided Raghuraji's name, then we don't require any other name to be seen after that. And we were very clear, all of us, that while giving this award to Raghuraji, it is not an honor to Raghuraji. It's an honor to the award. It's an honor to us, which we are going to do. So Raghuji, we are really thankful to you because you accepted our this offer, I can say, and really honored us. Thank you very much. We don't need Raghuraji, don't require any introduction. In India, he is an icon. In world, he is a creative master of photographers. He is a person. So all over the world, people know him. So we are really, again, thankful to you. We congratulate all the winners because it is a tough subject this time. When we talk about Skill India or Swachh Bharat, it's a big subject. But to take a photograph, convert it into a photograph, it is a tough subject. But people have done really good work. You must have seen outside some of the photographs which we have selected. They have done a wonderful work out of that. So we congratulate the people who have won. But the people who have not got award this time, they have also done a very good work. We have not selected because we have our limitations to select few. So I always congratulate them also and wish them ki in the next time they will get the award and their pictures will going to get a better one. Venkaiah ji, another thing which I want to say here about a photo division. Personally, I feel that your photo division is the one department which really works very hard. And this is the one department which always keep the history, visual history of this country. They are the custodians of this. And that's the reason we have a great names in photo division also. The people who have worked, Kashinath ji, T.S. Nagarajan ji, Mr. Majgaonkar, Mr. Prem Kapoor, Mr. Joginder Chawla, they were all become a good name in the world also. And still you have a good people like Sanjeev Mishra, Moitra, and all young photographers. They can really do a very good job. So we need this department should go further. And I always hope and wish under your leadership, this department will achieve another heights. Friends, again, I just thank all of you and congratulate all the winners and thank you for giving me this chance. Thank you very much, friends.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sinha. And now we will request the Honorable Suchna Prasaran Mantri Venkaiah Naidu Ji, Suchna Prasaran Rajya Mantri Colonel Rajyavardhan Rathore Ji, and Secretary INB Ajay Mittal Ji, se ki kripya puraskar vitran ke liye manch par samne ki taraf aa jaye. छठे राष्ट्रीय फोटोग्राफर्स अवार्ड्स का ये थीम जैसे कि आपने सुना प्रोफेशनल कैटेगरी स्किल इंडिया और एमेच्योर इंडिया और इसके लिए स्वच्छ भारत और आज के पुरस्कार वितरण की चार श्रेणियां पहली कैटेगरी स्पेशल मेंशन अवार्ड्स एमेच्योर कैटेगरी श्री दीपक भावकुमार कोल्हापुर महाराष्ट्र सुश्री प्रभा जयेश पटेल अहमदाबाद गुजरात सुश्री प्रभा जयेश पटेल अहमदाबाद गुजरात Shri Ravindra Mavi, Indore, Madhya Pradesh. Shri Sudipt Malik, Kolkata, Paschim Bengal. Shri Sumit Gulati, Delhi. Best Photographer of the Year, Amateur Category, Ravindra Kumar, Delhi. आपकी तालियों की कमी नहीं होनी चाहिए, समय की हो सकती है, तालियों की नहीं. और अब बारी है प्रोफेशनल कैटेगरी स्पेशल मेंशन अवार्ड्स की. श्री अतुल चौबे, महाराष्ट्र. Shri C.H. Narayan Rao, Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh. Shri Deepayan Bhar, Kolkata. Shri G. Nagashrinivasu, Tiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Shri O. P. Soni, Indore, Madhya Pradesh. अगली कैटेगरी बेस्ट फोटोग्राफर ऑफ द ईयर प्रोफेशनल कैटेगरी श्री के मुस्तफा केरल. और अब बारी है लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट अवार्ड की. और इस बार ये अवार्ड आप सब जानते हैं प्रदान किया जा रहा है एक ऐसा नाम जिससे हम सब परिचित हैं, रघु राय, जाने माने फोटोग्राफर. एक छोटी सी फिल्म उनके जीवन और कार्यों पर भी.
What is a still photograph? A simultaneous click of inner and outer world that comes together with, in a most intuitive and eloquent way that speaks for itself and that lives for itself forever and beyond. Monuments, landscape, it's the human beings who make a difference. It's the human beings who give a scale to the landscape, to the monument. For me, human beings are a very essential part of my life. And even if I am doing a landscape, I'll prefer to have somebody there, but not planted there as part of it. music, and especially Indian classical music, is the one that takes you to spiritual heights and connects you with spiritual experiences. And I have photographed them over the years, and not on regular basis, off and on. And I did it with a lot of passion, respect, and love for the musicians that I photographed. If anybody asks me, I don't think I have managed to capture all that is there in Indian classical music. There are moments where you can almost hear them. But there are other moments which are part of the story. And let me tell you, I make no big deal of anything. Even when I do my work, I do it with all my love and care. And once I've done, dekho, I've learned one thing. Duniya mein jao, dhoom machao, hangame kar do, ghar mein aao.
As if.
जोरदार तालियों के साथ एक बार फिर से अभिनंदन रेनाउंड फोटोग्राफर श्री रघुराय. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और आप सभी अवॉर्डीज को बहुत बहुत बधाई. और अब हम आमंत्रित करेंगे सूचना प्रसारण मंत्री माननीय वेंकैया नायडू जी को कि हमारा मार्गदर्शन करें.
फ्रेंड्स, आई एम इन अ लिटिल हरी बिकॉज पार्लियामेंट इज फंक्शनिंग नेवरडेज फॉर अ चेंज. I, being a minister, and that too being a former Parliament Affairs Minister, I cannot afford to be absent from the Parliament for long. Otherwise, I would have loved to be with you people, with this great company, for some more time. I was so much impressed and moved by the photography exhibition, the great artistic work done by many talented people across the country. I am particularly happy, and I would like to congratulate all the winners on this occasion. And my special regards go to Sri Raghurai for a lifetime of contribution in this field. I don't know whether he remembers, I was a small fry at that time. My first occasion to meet him was in 1984. When Mr. N.T. Ramarao, late N.T. Ramarao, the great actor, he was dismissed from the chief minister's post by a governor called as Mr. Ramlal in a most unceremonious manner, and installed a puppet as the chief minister at that time. I don't want to take his name. This is a good evening. I don't want to take such names also. Yeah. And then he had majority, he has undergone a heart operation in America. He came back. By the time he landed in India, he was dismissed. And the other puppet has been installed. So I was in opposition. I was not a part of that party. It was Telugu Desam party. But we all joined together to protect democracy and thus protest against autocracy. And then organized big campaign. All people across the country, they all came to Hyderabad. We collected together all the MLAs. We joined together, we went to Karnataka to take asylum for some time because there was harassment in Hyderabad. Then we brought all the 164 MLAs to Delhi to parade them in front of Rashtrapati Bhavan. Gyani Jail Singh was the president at that time. He was very kind enough, in spite of indications from above, not to meet us. He agreed to meet us, and then we all went and met him. But meanwhile, someone told me from Rashtrapati Bhavan, Mr. Naidu, you are all 164 MLAs are... You are parading here, but some of you are in Hyderabad being paraded before governor. I was surprised. We are all here. How can some of us be paraded in Hyderabad? Literally, I don't know what to do. Then from Rashtrapati Bhavan, I contacted Advaniji at that time. And Advaniji told me, do one thing, whoever is being paraded in Hyderabad, if you can get the names and segregate them and separate them and take a photograph of the people along with N.T. Ramarao in front of Rashtrapati Bhavan and send it to Hyderabad. So then we, Advaniji suggested that we should contact Raghurai, who was famous by that time. And then he was kind enough to come to Rashtrapati Bhavan and take a photograph of those MLAs who are supposed to have been paraded before the governor in Hyderabad, dubious MLAs, the original MLAs in Delhi. Asali, Delhi me, Nakidi, Hyderabad me. So he came and took the photograph along with N.T. Ramarao. He was holding a stick. He was not well those days. And then that photo, those days, this, what you call this transmission, automatic transmission, nothing was there. So you have to send it physically. So we requested someone who was going by the flight, evening flight, and we requested Indian Express Editor of Hyderabad and also Ramoji Rao, the Inadu, to little, what you call, delay their editions. Nowadays, even you give it at 12:30, also they can print. That time, this opportunity was not there. Then we sent these photographs to Hyderabad. Next day, front page of the story is original in Delhi, duplicate in Hyderabad, along with the photos. So there was no need to prove also. I remember those great days, and Raghurai is the best selection for a lifetime contribution in this field. I compliment the jury for making a proper decision. Friends, I would like to say one thing. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Without explaining, the picture explains itself. That is the greatness of this art, that is the greatness of this photography. The present world of fast-paced with real-time communication, photos are one of the best media of expression and information with confirmation. Photo is an information with confirmation. All other things, our journalist friends, they say sometimes, Naidu, this is the information. I stop them by saying this is information without confirmation. Come on, next question. Next question. But photo is an information with confirmation. They form a means of artistic statement that provides insight into the thought and mental makeup of communicator, in this case the photographer, while enabling them to transcend the limitations and boundaries of the linguistics of a written or spoken language. Photo speaks of all languages, Indian languages or even foreign languages also. There is no such barrier, linguistic barrier. It is often said that when you ask the people what possessions they would rescue from their burning house, one of the most frequent answer is photograph album. If there is some fire accident in your house, the first thing you want to rescue is the photographic album, because it's time, it will always be remembered, and then you can draw inspiration. Since the time immemorial, starting from the early pinholes cameras used in the 5th century BC, to the most latest DSLR high-tech cameras of today, the basic essence of photography is to freeze time. Has not changed. It is to present an object, a person, or a landscape as it stands in the current moment. It is rightly said that there are no specific set of rules to take a good photograph. A photographer is not bound by technique or theory. She or he is free to interpret the capture, the subject, the way he likes. This, I must say, makes it a complex occupation, and it is imperative to have the right amalgamation of art, angle, and aperture to capture and process the pictures, which only comes through years of practice. I sincerely compliment the professional photographers present here and also appreciate the amateur photographers. We have not taken the help of the rule book or technical theory to produce such beautiful pictures. I believe photography at its best is a powerful language which speaks to our emotions. It allows us to tell the story and show others our framing of the world around us. It is only through photography that we have been able to imagine our past, our history, and our bygone era. Through images captured related to events and personalities, photographs are indeed a part of our legacy. Just now, Raghuraji was mentioning about our culture, our music, our heritage and all. I call it as a visual language for some of the most difficult emotions. Colors used in the photograph have the subtle power to express hope, sorrow, grief, misery, guilt, happiness, joy, and elation, altering our mood at deep levels. We can learn lessons about a whole range of emotions through a photograph. In this context, I would like to draw your attention to some of the instances where photography displayed the power to move us by grabbing our attention and speaking directly to our emotions, thereby shaking our collective consciousness. The photograph of a three-year-old dead Syrian child washed ashore on a beach is an extraordinary, powerful image that changed the entire world opinion on the refugee crisis. Another example is the photograph of the terrorist Azmal Kassab engaged in brutal gun battle during the carnage of 26/11 attacks in Mumbai that has aroused strong public sentiment against the scourge of terrorism in and around the world. All these images strongly evoke deep reactions for more powerful than any other medium of communication can produce. Such pictures can truly help rally a large number of people for a particular cause. This all boils down to how an image is captured and the skills used by the photographer in bringing out the right emotions through her photos that strike a chord with the audience. Photography can be used as a means to spread awareness and a channel of good governance. Our government, under the visionary leadership of Narendra Modi, has launched digital applications for several schemes. The Swachh Bharat application, the behavioral change, the photography can also be a powerful instrument of social change. The selfie with the daughters campaign was launched to motivate parents to feel proud of their daughters in a gender-biased society. This way of posting photos with one daughter's carried a powerful impact on societal behavior and ingrained cultural traditions. Images and photos also help educate, as many of us are visual learners, whose memories contend more effectively if it happens to be image-based. Photos are much more than a simple record. Photographs allow us to share and communicate and fulfill the social need and desire of humans to share and showcase what we find beautiful and interesting with others. The internet has brought about the resurgence of the visual image to our everyday communication. Digital cameras and cell phones with integrated cameras have generated an explosion of images to everyone's lives. Photographs offer the benefit of instant and powerful communication, especially when the people's ability to read and write is not up to the mark. Social media channels are full of people sharing photographs to communicate with us. The maxim of today, everything exists to end in a photograph. That is the maxim today. This is more apt today. And photographs accompanying text always strengthens and augments the impact of your written words. I keep saying that Honorable Prime Minister Modi has given a three-word mantra. He said, reform, perform, and transform. Then I added, let us inform, because I am from the IMB ministry. The photograph is an information with confirmation. That way. Friends, that shows how important these photographs are. I would like to compliment Photo Division for organizing these awards on year-on-year basis. Photo Division is a media unit of the Ministry of IMB, meant for visual support for the varied activities of the Government of India. I am proud to say that it is the largest organization in the country in the production and storage of still photographs. Established in the year 1959, I am happy to note that the Photo Division has more than 10 lakh of negatives, transparencies, and now in digital format, right from the pre-independence time and up to the present day, which are of archival and historic value. Apart from documenting various activities of the central government, division has built up an invaluable collection of photographs on different aspects of Indian life, culture, flora and fauna, social and industrial growth. The main function of the division is to illustrate photographically the growth, the development, the social changes in the country. I hope they would continue to uphold this cause for many more years to come. I congratulate the Lifetime Achievement Award winner, Sri Raghurai, one of the best known photojournalist and a Padma Sri awardee in 72, the first time ever that a photographer was given Padma Sri in 1972. His passion for photography, I'm told, started in 1960s and continues to this day. He's happily engaged in recording contemporary India in all its beautiful facets and is an inspiration for all those who are associated with this. He served on the jury for the World Press Photo and twice on the jury of UNESCO International Photo Contest. This proves his provenness in the field garnered over multiple years of experience. I am glad to note that Raghurai has specialized in extensive coverage of India. He has produced more than 18 books, including Raghurai's Delhi, The Six, Calcutta, Khajuraho, Taj Mahal, Tibet in Exile, India, and the Mother Teresa. This year's theme of professional category was Skilled India. All this felicitation is to give inspiration. By just calling him onto the dais or giving him a memento or giving the other friends, the amateur photographers also, by memento or a certificate or even a cash reward, is not going to make much difference to them. But this felicitation is meant for inspiration to the new generation. That is the purpose of this program. That's why today, and we have these great people, galaxy people amongst us, including Raghurai and all, they are a great inspiration to the amateur, to the youngsters, and to the new generation, that they can also excel and they will also be complimented if they do good work. That is the purpose of this inspiration. Friends, I'm very happy about it. When I attend this function, I recollect the memory of missing the photograph of my mother. I lost my mother at the age of 1 year, 3 months. But unfortunately, I could not have a photograph of my mother. I always miss it, and then I could not even imagine how my mother used to be. People used to tell me that she's 5 feet, 7.5 inches, fair and very complex and very bright and all those things. But I always feel I miss something. So you can understand the importance of a photography by my own experience also. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद माननीय वेंकैया नायडू जी ने भावपूर्ण शब्दों में प्रोत्साहन देते हुए हम सबका मार्गदर्शन किया आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और वोट ऑफ थैंक्स के लिए अब हम आमंत्रित करेंगे ज्वाइंट सेक्रेटरी के संजय मूर्ति जी को कि वो आएं और वोट ऑफ थैंक्स करें
I express my sincere gratitude and thanks to the Honorable Minister of Information and Broadcasting for gracing the occasion, for taking time out of his busy schedule and to be with us today and providing encouragement to all the participants of these prestigious awards. I express my heartfelt gratitude to Colonel Rajyavardhan Rathore, Honorable Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting, for his graceful presence at the ceremony. My sincere thanks to our Secretary Shri Ajay Mittal for his support and constant guidance for organizing these awards. I wholeheartedly congratulate and expect my thanks to all the participants and winners of this year's awards and indeed to Shri Raghurai Ji for the Lifetime Achievement Awards. Yeah? Right. Sir? There is some, you can announce that. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Hum award winners or jury members se nivedan karenge, kripya manch par aayein ek group photograph ke liye. Aap sabhi se nivedan hai, zara fast, fatafat, manch par pradhane. एक ग्रुप फोटोग्राफ के लिए आप सभी से निवेदन है कृपया मंच पर जल्दी पधारें और आप सभी से हम निवेदन करेंगे कि जलपान की व्यवस्था की गई है फोर्थ फ्लोर पर इसके बाद जब माननीय मंत्री जी यहां से प्रवेश बाहर करेंगे उसके बाद आप कृपया जलपान के लिए सादर आमंत्रित हैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और इसी के साथ ये कार्यक्रम हम यहीं संपन्न करते हैं आप सभी जलपान के लिए फोर्थ